Hey, I'm Nat, and here are 17 things that will help you speed up and improve your logic workflow.
Tip number one, using the metronome. So by default, your metronome will sound like this. What you can do is if you hold control and click the metronome, you can then click metronome settings. Once the metronome menu is opened, you have all these different options. So what we want to do is just focus on the tone and volume, and then you can hear the difference when I hold and drag this, which helps your metronome to stick out more. And let's say it's still too quiet, you can turn up the volume like that. So that's just a cool little trick when it comes to using the metronome. Moving on to tip number two, dragging audio samples into your DAW. What you might be doing is selecting a loop and dragging it into your project, and then cutting up the relevant parts that you want to use. You might be dragging the relevant parts to wherever you want in your track. But if you want to cut down time and make your production faster, select the loop and drag it over to the track, and then drag it underneath the track area, you'll see the option for Quick Sampler Original, and it opens up the Quick Sampler. Click on Classic and open up your on-screen keyboard if you want by holding Command and K. One issue that you might come across is if you're playing your sample and go up to a higher note, it significantly increases tempo. So obviously we don't want that. So to stop that happening, all we need to do is click into our Quick Sampler, click this flex pitch icon here, and click follow tempo. Click back into our keyboard, and the tempo stays the same. If we close our Quick Sampler and we hit record, so that is one quick way of turning your audio sample into MIDI. Tip number three, using the automation curve tool. I've come across a certain issue when doing this. When I press play, my fader also moves up at the same time. What I suggest you do is automate the gain. Go to utility, then gain, leave this window open, change this from read to torch, and click the gain here. Close this window, and you need to make sure once you've finished adding that touch automation, you need to click the read automation. Now I can actually change the level of my fader whilst automation is going off. So that's just a cool little trick so that you can keep control over your volume. Tip number four, maybe at the minute you're playing some MIDI and you want to hear it from the middle of the MIDI note, but the MIDI note isn't actually playing. I've got a tip that will help you solve that. So if we head into our project, I've got some studio cellos in the project ready to play. If I play them from the start, they come in absolutely perfectly. But if I wanted to play it from the middle of the cellos, then I'll play from the middle of the note and no cellos are playing. So to fix that, all we need to do is go to File, Project Settings, down to MIDI. Once you're in the MIDI section, you want to click Chase and make sure that Notes is ticked. So now when I play the notes from the middle, I can hear them absolutely perfectly. Moving on to our next tip. Track alternatives. When you come to editing multiple takes in your project, it's best to flatten those takes first and then edit it. So for example, if we create a new audio track, and I just create a recording, and I just talk into the microphone like this. Now record it again. So I'm recording again, so I did it like that first take. Actually, no, I'll stop because I've messed up. And I'll do another take. This is take number three, and we're just doing take number three, just as an example. So now that you've got your take folder with your different takes in, you want to click on this A here, and then you want to flatten the takes. But now we've come up with an issue. I can't actually find my other takes. So what we want to do instead is control click on the track. We want to find track header components and then click track alternatives. So we'll duplicate it now. We will have an option now to select between track A and track B. What we can actually do is make track B our best take, then we can flatten that. And if it helps you, you can also rename these from A and B. Let's say we rename A to takes, and let's say we'll rename B to edit. We now have a takes and edit variation of our track. And whilst we're on the subject of recording different takes, let's look at the different cycle options that you have when you're recording your takes. So if we go to record, then overlapping audio regions, if we select create tracks and mute, and we'll create a loop here, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the loop, and we'll create a loop here. What it's doing is creating new tracks each time that it loops. Another option is if you go back into record, create track alternatives. Quick way of putting the cycle on, by the way, the shortcut is C. And we will just keep recording so that we can create a loop of recordings, and we'll keep creating loops here. What we've got now is take A, take B, take C. Moving on to tip number 7. I highly recommend that you get the Logic Pro app. And what you can do with this app is connect it to your DAW, and you can hit record from anywhere in the room. Tip number 8, we want to create audio into MIDI. This tip shows you how to convert a melody in your head straight into your DAW. At the moment, you might just have a melody in your head and you're trying to work it out on a keyboard or a guitar or whatever instrument that you've got, but you can't figure out what notes you're singing. So if we head into our DAW, record a melody that we've got in our head. Open up our editor by pressing E. Turn on flex where it says slicing, click on flex pitch. Then we want to click edit and scroll down to the menu and click create MIDI track from flex pitch data. And it's just a quick way of getting that down into MIDI rather than just trying to work those notes out that you've got in your head. Tip number 9, automatic quantizing. So if you want to set it to automatically quantize whilst you're recording, here's how you do it. Head into the track settings where it says off, you want to click on whatever note is relevant to you. Open up our keyboard and then we'll hit record. And now it's completely in time. Look at that, perfectly in time. Moving on to tip number 10, fade zones. So if we balance this MIDI track in place and we wanted to create fade ins and outs, one way of doing it is by going into the region settings, clicking on more, and then we've got fade in and fade out options here. So I can add in my fade in. So let's put in 1,000 just for example. If I wanted to make it shorter, I can half it to 500 and so on. But there is a much quicker way of doing this. So if I head into my preferences, you can do this by hitting the shortcut command, comma. Then I want to be in the general section and then clicking editing, select fade tool click zones. Once that's selected, what I can now do is once I hover my mouse into the top corner of the audio, then if I click and hold down, I can now add in fades, just like that. And I can do it to the end as well. Whilst we're on the topic of fades, another cool trick is that you can turn your fade ins and outs into slowdowns or speed ups. What I can do is change this fade in to a speed up. Now play it. How cool does that sound? Just gives it more life and energy. Then I can do the same for the end. If I change this fade out to a slow down. There we go. How cool is that? Okay, so moving on to the next tip, freezing tracks. So let's say I've got a load of plugins that are making my project slow. What I can do to help that, to help stop that, is click into my track, right click on it, then go into track editor components, and then where it says freeze, you want to click freeze. So what you've got now is an option to freeze your track with this little snowflake icon here. What that does is if I click it and hit the space bar, it runs through my whole project and it freezes that one track. What it's technically done is bounced it down into a smaller file size. So it means it's using less CPU to run your project. So when I hit play, it will run absolutely fine. It will run perfectly fine. But it stops these plugins being processed because it's processed it already by freezing the track. So if you want to make any further edits, all you need to do, click on this snowflake icon again, and then you can make any further edits to any of the plugins that you've got. Okay, moving on to the next tip, tempo automation. So if you want your track to change tempo throughout, and this is how you do it, head into your project, click the global settings. Let's say we wanted the automation to happen over this section here. We would add the endpoint, and let's say we wanted it to drop from 120 BPM to around 100 BPM. We'll drag this down to 100 BPM, and then let's say we wanted this tempo change to happen exactly on this point here. Drag the line back, and let's press play and hear how that sounds. So there you go, that's how you change the tempo throughout your project. If you wanted that to happen gradually, then this is how you do it. You select this point here and then drag it back. So the tempo change isn't as sudden. If you can't actually see the tempo settings in the global settings, control click on this section here in the global settings, and you want to make sure that the tempo is ticked. Let's move on to the next tip, which is moving a bus channel into your project area. So at the moment, I've got this Soundwave grand piano being sent to bus 4 and 3, but I can't actually see them in my project area. Tap X to open up the mixer window, and we'll drag this down so that we can see the project at the same time. And we have our buses here. So we have bus 3 and 4. I want these buses to show in my project area, but they're not at the minute. If you see this red here, or read, all you need to do is click this power on button here. So if I tap that, that now appears in my project area. So that's one way of getting your bus into your project area. Okay, moving swiftly on to the next tip, which is creating presets. So let's say you wanted to save a set of plugins that you've got on your channel. And let's say I wanted to add in, I don't know, some gain, and then we maybe want some isotope trash in there, because why not? If I wanted to save that set of plugins, all I would need to do is this. Click on the channel settings, and I move down to save channel strip settings as, and we'll save it exactly where it's wanting us to save it, and we'll save it. We'll create a new audio track, and let's say we wanted to load those settings in. All we would need to do is click on settings, then move down to the bottom, and we can see Soundwave grand piano crazy effects XX, however you say that, is there, and we just click on it and it loads in our settings that we created earlier. And that's just a quick way of saving presets. Okay, so moving on to the next tip, which is creating project alternatives. Let's say you want to make a better version or a remix or an acoustic version of the track that you're creating. All you need to do is do the following. Head into File, we go down to Project Alternatives, create a new alternative. Now we want to save a new alternative. So let's change this to Example 1 and change it to Example 1 Remix. So if we head into our file and we go down to Project Alternatives, we have an Example 1 Original and an Example 1 Remix. So if I made changes to this now, let's say move this over here, save the project, go into File, Project Alternatives, go to the original version. My original project is still there. Then if we go back to the remix version, you can see my changes are still there that I made earlier. So that's just a quick way of making project alternatives. Moving on to this last tip. It's a very quick tip, but it's useful for helping to keep your project organized. So let's say I wanted to make these regions different colors. All I would need to do is click on the region, hold Option on my keyboard, and press C at the same time, and now I get these options up here, so I can change my color of my region. So let's say I wanted to go for a nice bright pink to a blue, I can do that as well. So that's just a very quick way of changing your regions to different colors so that you can easily identify your regions and work in a nice organized project. If you've come here, then you're most likely a beginner music producer. You might not know much about your piano scales or scales in general. So what I've done is put together a video talking through the scales and the easiest method for remembering your scales. So I highly recommend checking this video out.